Welcome students, English High School SSC online audio video lessons. I am Nidhi Srivastav, your science teacher for standard 8th. Today I am going to teach you chapter number 5, part 1, Inside the Atom. So let's start. This is the structure of an atom. Inside the atom, we have seen that matter is made of molecules. Molecules are formed from atoms. Effectively, an atom is the smallest unit of matter. An atom is the smallest particle of an element which retains its chemical identity in all the physical and chemical changes. The concept of atom is more than 2500 years old. Many scientists, on the basis of experiments, explained the nature and internal structure of atom. It started with Dalton's atomic theory. Dalton's atomic theory, British scientist John Dalton put forth in 1803 AD his celebrated atomic theory. According to this theory, matter is made of atoms and atoms are indivisible and indestructible. All atoms of an element are alike, while different elements have different atoms with different mass. To understand this theory, you have to do an activity. Take a solid ball and a bundi laddu. Press both these spheres with your palms. What did you find? Number two, cut the solid ball with sharp knife. What did you find? See, a bundi laddu is found to have an internal structure. It is formed by sticking smaller particles, the bundis, to each other. However, the solid ball, broadly speaking, does not have any internal structure. We all know. The atom, as described by Dalton, turns out to be a hard, solid sphere with no internal structure. According to Dalton's atomic theory, the mass is distributed uniformly in an atom. See, this image shows the great scientist John Dalton, who was English chemist, proposed atomic theory in 1803, and his proposed atomic model. Next theory is Thomson's plum pudding model of atom. Plum pudding is a type of cake. The plum pudding model of atom put forth by Thomson in the year 1904 is the first model of atomic structure. According to this model, the positive charge is distributed throughout the atom and the negatively charged electron are embedded in it. The distributed positive charge is balanced by the negative charge on the electrons. Therefore, the atom becomes electrically neutral. See, this is the image of plum pudding atomic model by J.J. Thomson. Next theory is Rutherford's nuclear model of atom, which is given in 1911. Rutherford studied the inside of atom by his celebrated scattering experiment and put forth the nuclear model of atom in the year 1911. Rutherford took a very thin gold foil thickness 10 raised power minus 4 millimeter and bombarded it with positively charged alpha particles emitted by a radioactive element. He observed the path of alpha particles by means of a fluorescent screen around the gold foil. It was expected that the alpha particles would get reflected from the gold foil if the positively charged mass were evenly distributed inside the atoms. Unexpectedly, most of the alpha particles went straight through the foil. A small number of alpha particles get deflected from the original path through a small angle. A still smaller number of alpha particles get deflected through a larger angle, and surprisingly, one alpha particle out of 20,000 bounced back in the direction opposite to the original path. The large number of the alpha particles that went straight through the foil indicates that there was no obstacle in their path. It means that there must be mainly an empty space inside the atoms in the solid gold foil. The small number of alpha particles that get deflected through a small or a big angle must have forced an obstacle in their path. It means that the positively charged and heavy part causing obstruction would be in the center of the atom. See, this is the image which shows Rutherford's experiment. From this, Rutherford put forth a nuclear model for atom as follows. There is a positively charged nucleus at center of an atom, number one. Number two, almost the entire mass of the atom is concentrated in the nucleus. Number three, negatively charged particles called electrons revolve around the nucleus. Number four, the total negative charge on all the electrons is equal to the positive charge on the nucleus. As the opposite charges are balanced, the atom is electrically neutral. Number five, there is an empty space between the revolving electron and the atomic nucleus. See, this is the image of Rutherford's nuclear model of the atom, which shows the nucleus is very small, dense, and positively charged. Electrons surround the nucleus. Most of the atom is empty space. Next is Bohr's stable orbit atomic model, which is given in 1913. In the year 1913, Danish scientist Niels Bohr explained the stability of atom by putting forth a stable orbit atomic model. The important postulates of Bohr's atomic model are as follows. The electrons revolving around the atomic nucleus lie in the concentric circular orbits at certain distance from the nucleus. Number two, energy of an electron is constant while it is in a particular orbit. When an electron jumps from an inner orbit to an outer orbit, it absorbs energy equal to the difference of its energy level. And when it jumps from an outer orbit to an inner orbit, it emits energy equal to the difference of its energy level. Some more atomic models were put forth after Bohr's atomic model. Atomic structure was studied at depth with the advent of a new branch of science called quantum mechanics. With all those, some well-accepted fundamental principles of atomic structure are as follows. See, this is the image of Bohr's stable orbit atomic model, 1913. He was a great scientist, and this image shows its atomic model, positively charged nucleus in the center, and shells 1, 2, 3, 4, which is named as K shell, L shell, M shell, N shell, respectively. Next topic, we will continue in part 2 video. Thank you, dear students.